How you doing, Manginas? Angry Toddler here, bringing you guys Gun Game on Bacara Bananas. And there's actually another gameplay on Carbon after this. And you guys have loved the Girlfriend Story series, so why not continue it? And you guys have been asking for the third one, so here it is. And so, last time we left off talking about Cassie and Adriana. And I actually remember the next day when I was going through and, when it was on my channel, I was going through the comments, I was like, her name wasn't actually Adriana, it was Adrian. I know it's a guy's name, but I guess she was going both ways with the names her parents were, I guess. But yeah, her name was Adrian, and so that, I don't know why, it's not really that important, but it's just kind of, I don't know why I called her Adriana. So anyways, these two girls, if I already said, they hated each other, and so they started having an argument with each other, and I got involved, which sucked, but their argument came from, who would I rather have sex with? And so they argued that I would rather have sex with one of them or whatever. So whenever they would ask me to, first of all, I never had a first kiss. I never kissed anybody at this point. So I'm like, and I was one of those kids that's like, I'm never going to have sex until I get married. And that's how I was for a while. That kind of changed. But I'm not a whore. I'm not a whore, but yeah. So anyways, I'm not going to talk about it. Oh, fuck, I lost my train of thought. Okay, so yeah, they kept arguing, but I was like, well, neither of you guys. It's what I would say, because by then, I didn't have interest in either of them. So, here's what happened after school one day. They decide, you know what, we're pissed at each other. We never liked each other, so let's just throw punches at each other. So they got in a literal fist fight after school. I'm not sure who won. I wasn't there. I was already at home, I think, by the time the fight started. And the next day, I get called into the office. And I've never talked to the principal before. He's never talked to me. And he's like, so, do you know why I called you in here? And I'm like, no. He's like, well, do you know Cassie and Adrian? And I was like, yeah, I know them. They're like, well, they got in a fight yesterday, and they said you were the cause of it. And I'm like, wait, why did they say that? And I said, I wasn't even there, and I don't even talk to them anymore. And they're like, well, they said they blamed it on you. That was your fault for them fighting. And so the guy was like, the principal was like, so you need to stay away from them. And like, you need to like keep a distance. And first of all, I don't think that the principal should have a right to tell me who I should stay away from. I think I should have the right to talk to whoever I want. And so I thought that was bogus. And I kind of said that too. I told him, well, I don't talk to him anyways. And I really don't, I usually stay away from him. But I said, I don't really think you can tell me to stay away. And he's like, well, that's true. He said, but you can get in trouble again about this. And there'll be more trouble next time. And I told him, I'm like, I didn't even start a fight. It wasn't even me. I don't get how I'm in trouble in this situation. So it was kind of stupid. But yeah, that was kind of the end of that little fiasco with Man Bear Pig and Witchcraft. So after that, here's the best girlfriend story of them all. And some of you guys might remember this from a past commentary. But I had a stalker in high school. And it's not one of those normal stalkers where this person has a huge crush on you. And like writes love letters and like confesses it's their love for you. It's a little different in my situation. My stalker, and I don't mean this in any way. I have nothing against these people. I'm not making fun of them at all. So I'm just telling you the situation, all right? My stalker had Down syndrome, and she was really good at stalking. I have to say, she was excellent at stalking. And how it started was, she met me in eighth grade. At one of those dances, actually, one of my friends who worked with them introduced me to her. She's like, I've seen you before, and so she remembered my name after that. So in the hallway, she passed by to me, and she's like, hi, Ryan, and I'd say, hi, Casey, what was her name, Casey. I know it's similar to Cassie, but yeah, so Casey would say hi to me and stuff. So once we hit high school, once we went to the high school, in my high school, it's sophomores through seniors, so it's 10, 11, 12th grade, and we have 8th and 9th grade buildings separate. I think I already said that in the past one. But, anywho, she started having a little bit more than a crush on me. And so, how it actually started was, I was at this dance. And I was at the dance with my girlfriend at the time. She's 2 years too long. I'll explain her probably in a future episode if I don't get to her in this one. But, Cassie won the dance. Casey, sorry. I'm getting fucking mixed up now. Casey won the dance with me. So she sees me right away at the dance, and she's like, come dance with me. And I was like, Casey, I'll dance with you a little bit later. I just got here. I'm not going to dance yet. She's like, no, come dance with me, just one song. She kept bugging me, tugging at my arm. So my girlfriend was like, just go dance with her once. And I was like, okay. So I went to go dance with her. And by the way, not bumping and grinding, because I know that's what you guys would write in the comments, that I was bumping and grinding this chick. I was probably like 3 feet away from her, just grooving off to some rap song, which was hilarious. It was some gangster rap song. But I was just talking to her. I was like, so how do you like the dance? How do you like the song? Trying to make small talk, because it was really awkward. So then I went to leave, and she yelled at me, and she got really mad, she yelled at me, and I have no clue of what she said or what she was talking about. And I'm like, well, that's weird. So I went with my group, it was just four of us, standing in a circle talking. And so I see her dancing like probably 8 feet away, and she kept looking back at me. And I was like, hey guys, we should probably move, because she just keeps looking back at me, it's just kind of weird. So we move away. We move a little bit to the other side of the gym, which we're dancing. It's so stupid why we have to do dances in the gym. But she followed us, and she found us again. She was doing the same thing, dancing a little bit away, looking back at me. And so finally, she came up to my girlfriend, tapped her on the shoulder, and said, this is a quote. I'm not going to quote the way she said it, but the words were, go sit on the side, he's mine. Referring to me. So she told my girlfriend to go sit in the side and not dance with anybody, so to dance with me. And when that happened, I'm just like, fuck me. Not literally, okay? I didn't mean it literally, all right? So I just had to clarify that, because I see your guys' comments. I know what you guys would say, so don't say it. I did not say I wanted to fuck her, okay? We got that clear? All right. So the rest of the dance, the main mission was to hide from her, not have her see me. And I guess she went up to somebody. Actually went up to Cassie, because Cassie thought me and her were still chill, and I couldn't stand her. I hated her. But she went up to Cassie and told her, where's Ryan's ugly girlfriend at? And I was just like, what? I was like, who says that? I don't care if you have a problem or not. I thought it was hilarious. So after the dance, the next day at school, I thought I was like, alright, maybe it's this thing that's going to happen at the dance. Nope! It continued. It actually continued for 4 more months, and I'm running out of time on this commentary, so I'm going to pick up the rest of the stories on the next one, because there is a lot of them, and they are quite funny. For instance, she would follow me to all my classes, and she kept wanting me to go to girls' choir with her. So she was so desperate for me to go to girls' choir with her, she followed me all the way into the boys' locker room for PE, and until a teacher saw her and had to escort her out of the room, and she was crying. I felt bad. I mean, but what am I supposed to do? I'm in high school. I'm trying to save my, I want to say, I don't know. I'm trying to be nice in the situation, but it was really weird. So the rest of the stories will be next episode. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Stay hairy, manginas.